These words are basically techniques.
Are basically techniques. How semiotics can be used. There are colors which can be used to greater
different colors
have different connotations. There are iconography, images, statues, figures, paintings, sketches.
There are stylistic
quotes. We have to understand that we are talking about cinema. Cinema is an art form which has its own language. Language comprises of using the camera,
capturing an image,
putting it on the editing table, joining it as per the sensibility and the vision of the director.
And presenting it in front of the audience.
So semiotics is a very important part of the language of cinema.
Because
it is not only the image which can do everything.
It is not only the sound
which
can
express everything. It is not only the dialogues which can express
everything.
There is something other than these.
Which creates
or which instills meaning into cinema. Coming to Bengali parallel cinema. The first question is, why do we
say parallel cinema?
So the automatically the question comes. Parallel to what? So we have to understand that in our country, we have a mainstream entertainment industry.
In the very beginning, we had our own
religious rituals.
From the rituals
came performances,
cultural performances.
Slowly and gradually, these came to be known as traditional
media.
Every province in India has its own traditional media. It is known as, say for example, in West Bengal, in Malda,
we have
the Gombhira dance.
In Murshidabad,
we have the Alka,
Leto.
In Punjab, we have the Bhangra.
In Jammu,
we have the Dogri.
In Maharashtra,
we have the Lavri.
These are all the traditional
entertainment and educational media.
When the British took over our country, a Western form of cultural practice.
Public drama and theatre started, especially in West Bengal.
With Girish Chandra Ghosh setting up the Bengal Theatre, Great National Theatre. From theatre,
then emerged cinema.
There were different schools of cinema.
There was the Parsi cinema, which Mr. Madan had pioneered.